Hello everyone, welcome back to Nigerian View. So guys, there is another cult war in Delta State, and this cult war is between Black Ass and Supreme Vikings Confraternity. This cult war started last week, and as we speak, two people have went down and a lot of people have been injured. I didn't speak about this because I was trying to get information about what was really going on, and a lot of people has reached out to me as usual. They explained to me and they want me to bring this out to people so people will be aware of what is going on. So that is what we are going to do. But before we go into it, please take a moment of your time to like this video. It is very important that you like this video and subscribe to this channel if you haven't, so you can get more updates about the things that are going on. So let's get into it. So according to what is going on, a lot of people don't know what happened between these two rival cults. But it is said that on Tuesday last week, some young men that were well dressed went into the campus of the Delta State Polytechnic in Ogara, and they went into classes. A lot of people said the way these young men were walking, it seemed like they were looking for someone. They went into about 3-4 classes and they later went into the cafeteria. That is where they found the person they were allegedly looking for, and from the eyewitness, they brought down this man using a block. I think they used a block to smash his head or something like that. After they did this, they walked out of the campus and nobody could stop them. They just walked straight out of the campus. The man wasn't down, the man was still breathing, and they took the man to the medical center, but the nurses were unable to help and they said the man should be taken to the hospital. Before they took this young man to the hospital, this young man went down. And it was also said that that same day, another person went down in the community of Ogara. This person that went down is a 35 years old man, and he is said to be an indigene of this community. And a lot of people were injured, a lot of people that they tried to bring down that they couldn't. These people were severely injured and a lot of them are receiving treatment in the hospital. The police later became involved because it is said that one of these confraternity members were also shot by the police. But fortunately for him, he did go down. So he is currently receiving a treatment on this closed hospital. Because of this, the authority shut down the polytechnic for 2 weeks. So as we speak, it is remaining about a week for this polytechnic to open. And they are trying to talk to these confraternity members peacefully for them to put down their weapons, for them to stop fighting. This is the situation right now in the community. And it is said that this community is very popular for bringing people down. The cult war in this community is too much because they have the polytechnic there, and there are a lot of cult members in the polytechnics, and there are a lot of cult members also that are indigenous of the community. So there is always cult war in this community. At this time, it seems like even when you try to expose these things that are going on to people, even when you try to advise people, I know my platform is very small. A lot of these young men see my videos, they reach me on WhatsApp, they talk to me, and some of them explain that they regret being a member of a confraternity and they don't want to participate anymore. But a lot of them are scared to come out openly and say they don't want to participate anymore because they don't know what might happen to them. To me, I think it's a good step that a lot of them are having remorse about what is going on. But the people that are bringing down other people, I don't know how the youth can pass message to these people and tell them to stop doing what they are doing. Alright, in my opinion, I think these confraternity members can fight if they want to fight. They can fight with their hands, they can fight with their fist, then after that, they settle everything. I think when we were growing up, this is what we used to do. When you have problems with someone, you bring up your fist and you fight. After fighting, you and this person becomes friend again. I think this is the best way to live, because bringing someone down really don't solve the problem. When you bring someone down, you have a blood in your head, and this blood in your head is not going to do you any good. We should try as much as possible to reduce this confraternity. If we can't stop it, it's okay. These confraternities can exist if these people can just live in peace. Or if they have problems, they can fight with their hands. It's better. After fighting, maybe you have a few bruises, you go to hospital and treat yourself, and this person remains your friend. There is no need to bring people down. Anyway, I just quickly want to pass this message. I remember your boy, Nigerian View.